Hi, I'm Dick Norris from Expedition 361, the South African Safari. And I'm sailing today in the Agulhas Current. Ever heard of that? Well, it turns out the Agulhas is one of the biggest rivers on Earth. It transports something like 70 million cubic meters of water every second. And that turns out to be comfortably more than any river on land. The Mississippi, for instance, transports only about 17,000 cubic meters of water a second. And even the mighty Amazon, the biggest terrestrial river on Earth, moves only around 200,000 cubic meters of water a second. So contrast that with the Agulhas's 70 million and you get my drift. Now the Agulhas is a current that flows along the East African coastline, and it flows down towards the Cape of Good Hope in long sort of loopy meanders that remind me quite a bit of ink sinking in a glass of water. So why should you care about any of this? Well, it turns out that the Agulhas probably figures very closely in the history of early humans. And that's because the Agulhas has warm and cool phases. And when it's warm, a lot of evaporation gets transported to nearby Africa, where it creates a profusion of vegetation on land that would create a rich haven of wildlife for early humans. And on the other hand, when the Agulhas is in a cool phase, it doesn't evaporate so readily, and as a consequence, we get less rainfall on eastern Africa, and early human ancestors had to come down out of the trees because now there was just savanna to walk around on, and they had to become relatively flexible to figure out how to make life work in a dry, arid landscape. So fundamentally, we owe our origins substantially to this current.